Why is my mail to this person not getting through? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. It's frustrating at times, even after all of these years, spam remains a huge, huge problem. And unfortunately, with that problem comes what I would call collateral damage. Legitimate email not making it to its destination, or ending up in spam folders. If you're seeing that consistently with email you send or email you send to some specific person, I've got some ideas that you can at least look into to try and understand what might be going on. To be clear, when legitimate email is blocked, be it actually blocked or simply sent into a spam folder, it is for either of two reasons. That email, that message, that specific message looks too much like spam. In other words, the system spam filter has analyzed the contents of the message and decided that in comparison to the billions of messages that it's already seen, yours looks a little bit too much like spam. And therefore, it gets blocked or it gets filtered. The other is a little not quite as obvious. But that is, the system thinks that your system, your email service provider, your email services server has a bad reputation. Much of spam filtering these days is based on reputation. And if you find that your service has been sending lots and lots and lots of spam in the past, then it's possible that you sending completely innocuous, totally legitimate email might suffer the consequences because the receiving system might say, hey, you're coming from this service that has a really bad reputation, therefore you must be sending spam too. Looking like spam is kind of an odd thing to try and define. There's the obvious stuff, right? Like sexually explicit terms or phrases, certain drugs, shouting. Writing in all caps can also cause your mail to look a little bit more like spam. Fake or inconsistent or bad return addresses, or return addresses that don't match the display name. HTML email. Used to be that HTML email or rich text email was a big problem. It's not as much anymore, but it still kind of counts. And of course, marketing terms. I get notice from this from some of the tools that I use all the time, where I'm using a phrase that is commonly used in marketing. Well, you know what? That kind of, sort of, makes the email look a little bit more like spam. Now, I have to point out, these are not absolutes. You can do many, some, all of these things and not have a problem. The problem is that they each count against you sometimes, usually. Right? So if you're doing one of them, okay, may not be a problem. If you're doing multiples of them, well, maybe that's enough to skew the deck, skew the analysis, and have you suddenly fall into, yep, this is looking a little bit too much like spam. Unfortunately, it gets worse because while this kind of analysis absolutely does happen, ultimately, what is and is not spam is in the eye of the beholder. It's in the eye of the recipient. So, if, for example, you send a totally innocuous, totally legitimate email to someone, they mark it as spam for whatever reason. Okay, that system now has taken your message and added it to its pile of, this is stuff that looks like spam. You send a very similar message again. Well, you know, there haven't been too many reports of that specific email or you or your content or whatever having been reported as spam, but now your recipient does it again. And again, and again, and again. The issue here then is that because the recipient is saying over and over and over again that this is spam, whatever it is, the system is going to start to consider it spam. Now, it's rare that an individual will get a message and get the same message over and over again and mark it spam over and over again. But if you send a message to a large number of people, and a large number of people mark it as spam, then the system, the receiving system, is going to pay attention. It's going to say, you know what? A lot of people think this is spam. So I'm going to weigh it fairly heavily when I take a look at subsequent messages that come in from this service, from this user, from whatever. If they look like this, or if this person's reputation says that, you know what, they've been sending spam according to my recipients, that too may cause your message to start getting flagged or blocked as spam, regardless of what's inside. If the recipient thinks it's spam, if enough recipients think it's spam, then yep, eventually it's going to be marked as spam. There's almost nothing you can do about this. If the recipients think it's spam, almost by definition, it's spam. So another part of this is what I referred to earlier as email reputation. If the system, this email service that you're using to send your mail, has a bad reputation, well, that could impact you. If you send your email through your own server, say you own your own domain and you're doing all your email through your own hosted server, your server has a reputation. That reputation counts regardless of the content of your message. That means that in many cases, the only way to get a better reputation is to change who's sending your email. In years past, it used to be that Hotmail had a very bad reputation for being a source of a tremendous amount of spam. The advice at the time was to use something else. Change your email provider. Hotmail, now Outlook.com, they're better. They don't get flagged as spam disproportionately compared to other email providers, but the thinking still holds. There are email providers, and especially newsletter providers, that have a reputation for sending more spam than others. Therefore, they are going to be flagged as spam or blocked as spam more often than others. The only solution, again, is to switch providers to one that has a better reputation. It's one of the reasons that I've stuck with AWeber.com for so many years, because they have a really good reputation, they have high standards, and it's uncommon for anything they send to automatically be flagged as spam. Now, one thing I do want to point out here is that spam rarely bounces. In other words, you could send something and it could end up in somebody's spam folder, or it could be blocked completely. You'll never know. And the reason you'll never know is because some spam, some actual spam, is designed to bounce. And it's designed to bounce to someone else who would then get it and react to it. There are so many spam messages that if every piece of spam that should bounce actually was bounced, the internet would be flooded with nothing more than bounced messages going back and forth. The bottom line is that most email providers do not bounce spam. You cannot count on it. The only thing you can do to understand whether or not your recipient actually got your mail is if they didn't reply to it, you got to ask them, and possibly ask them using some other channel that isn't email, because otherwise you wouldn't know if it was the original email that didn't make it through or your question. The best you can do, of course, is don't write email that could look like spam. That part's given. It's frustrating because what looks like spam doesn't have a solid definition. It really doesn't. The other thing, of course, is pay attention to the reputation, if you can, of the systems that you're using. Gmail's pretty good these days. Outlook.com, okay-ish. Yahoo, maybe not so much. There are so many others out there that if you find yourself running into this problem, one of the first things I would do is simply try sending that same message using a different email provider to see if it makes it through. If it does, that tells you a little bit about what may be causing your message not to go through. I hope that's helpful. I hope that helps you at least understand what could be going wrong if you've got email that isn't making it to specific recipients. For updates, for comments, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/1856. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.